Good morning, EE Sports fans. This is John Cannon coming to you from the Ekiah Tales Athletic Complex. I am here with this week's Player of the Week, George Gomez. George had a huge game where he had over 100 yards rushing and a couple of touchdowns to his credit in a huge win over Los Fresnos. George, congratulations on Player of the Week and congratulations on the win over Los Fresnos. Out of the gates, man, you showed that you're going to be the guy. Talk about Friday night, man, and how did it feel to get back on the field and to have the performance that you did?
Feels good to be back on the field, doing what I love. If it wasn't for my O-line, then I wouldn't be able to do what I did.
You know, this year, a lot of the pressure's on you. You know, you guys are becoming more of a running team. I'm sure you got to kind of like that. Last year, you were more of a passing offense. You still got your carries.
Yeah.
But now that the focal point's on the run game and on you, how does it feel?
I just need to get in the way of doing more cardio, so no injuries can happen. It feels better.
You know, one thing I noticed, man, you slimmed up a lot. What did you do over the summer? Did you spend some time in the gym, try to cut some weight, or talk about that a little bit?
I worked harder, so because I knew it was going to be a big year this year, and I just did what I had to do.
As a senior, you know, what are your personal goals? Last year, you were 1,000 yards back. What are your goals this year, knowing that this is it, this is your last ride?
To break this record.
Really?
Yeah, 2,000 yards.
Okay. This week you got a big game against Vela. You remember last year that was one heck of a finish, one heck of a game. What can we expect this year now with you guys going over there?
You can expect a lot because our team's real young, but we know what we're doing and we just expect a lot.
There you go. A couple of questions I'm going to ask you just to kind of get to know you a little bit. One thing I thought of is, if I were a college recruiter and I came to you and said, hey, George, I am a recruiter for the state of Texas, and I'm here to offer you any job in the state to play football, which college would you choose and why would that be?
I'm not sure.
Any school. You can pick any college in Texas. You're not sure? Do you have a team in preference that you like?
The Longhorns.
Okay, so what if the Longhorns gave you an opportunity? Would you jump on it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If I was an NFL scout and I came and said, hey, you know, I'm impressed with your running style. I think that you've got what it takes to play at the NFL level. But you can choose any team that you want to play for. However, it has to be a rebuilding team. Which team would that be and why?
The
building team's going to be like maybe Cleveland, maybe the Jets, or, you know, a team that really needs a run game.
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere like that.
That'd probably be Cleveland.
Cleveland? Why Cleveland?
Because everyone doubts him.
Okay.
Just, we got to prove people wrong.
You know, now that you've lost all this weight, what is it you have to do to maintain that, to make sure that you don't gain it?
Just been in the weight room every time, all day.
What about meal-wise? Have you changed your eating habits and stuff?
Not really. Just been working out a lot.
The day of a game, what is it that you do to try to remain focused and to prepare for it?
Well, just being school points first, and once I get to the field house, I turn on the switch and just get into game mode.
When you put that helmet on, you step in the field the first time, how would you describe yourself?
Unstoppable.
Really?
Yeah.
If you could pick a, because you know, some people say they feel like a tank, uh-huh, or they feel like a truck, or they feel like, if you could describe in maybe a word, what would you say you feel like?
I'm not sure.
Like a machine, maybe?
I guess so, yeah. Machine.
Okay. Besides football, what's your second favorite sport?
Track.
Do you compete in track here?
Yes.
Okay. What events do you compete in?
The 100 and the 200 and the 400.
Really? So more of the speed?
Yeah.
Okay. Last year, you guys went 3 deep in the playoffs.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for the past couple of years, I've been 3 deep in the playoffs. What are your team goals this year that you want to accomplish?
To go 5-0 like we did last year.
Really? Yes. Looking at the schedule, what's the one game you can't wait for?
Machines.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. If there was one defensive player you could face in the Valley, who would that be and why?
I don't know, I've never really looked.
Or one defense?
The Vets.
Vets defense? Mm. Okay. Who's your favorite running back?
Adrian Peterson.
Adrian Peterson?
Yeah.
Okay. Looking at the way you run, who would you compare yourself to as a running back? Mm-hmm. If you could compare.
Everyone's saying that I look like Marshawn.
Like Marshawn Lynch? Okay. But you don't take a knee, right, like he does?
Huh?
You don't take a knee like he does, right, Lee Anthem? There you go. The hair, man, first thing I noticed. What happened? You had to cut it, right? It was a school policy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Does it feel different? Do you feel different with it cut? So what do they call you now? Last year they called you Samoan. What do they call you now? They don't call you the Samoan guy anymore? Okay. Realistically, have you talked to any schools yet about the opportunity about playing college football? You haven't. Have you looked at any? Is there any that you would like to play for? I know, like, there's A&M Kingsville right down the road, a couple other ones that some guys have played here. Do you have any preferences if you could play, or some places that you'd like to pursue?
Kingsville would be nice to go to.
Kingsville would be nice to go to? Okay. Who would you say on the team has been your biggest motivator, the guy that's motivated you the most?
Mack Lauder.
Really? Why is that?
Because he came back from an injury last year and he's working harder than what he did.
Okay. What about coaches? Which coach would you say has been the biggest influence in your life?
Coach Mike Chalai, because he's always pushing me to do what I can do.
Okay. Family-wise?
My dad.
Why?
Because he's always helping me with whatever I need.
Okay. Last question. What is your message to everybody going forward? A lot of people this year doubted you, saying you lost so many seniors, that this is going to be a down year. It's going to be a rebuilding year for the Jackets. You proved people wrong week one. What do you want to say to all those people who are still doubting you?
Just come out to every game so we can prove you guys wrong.
There you go. Well, George, once again, congratulations on being Player of the Week, and good luck this week against Embry-Riddle.
Thank you.